Welcome to today's Jazz Tube. Today I'd like to talk about Back Home in Indiana. Back Home in Indiana is a 32-bar song form, which is most popularly known as the chord progression to Donna Lee. I have composed an etude that basically covers three concepts. One is continuous eighth note line usage, which is a very good technical study for people who don't have to read, guitar players, piano players. The second concept is the use of chromaticism as realized in terms of bebop scales. And really, quite simply, that's just using chromatic passing tones to put chord tones on the downbeat so we can outline chord changes. The last concept is the use of bebop lick cliches, and I've chosen for this study to use the licks that have been codified in the teachings of Barry Harris, known as the 5-4-3-2 licks. So these are really important licks. They're good to help you get out of trouble. If you have nothing else to play, knowing these licks is a very good idea because they sound idiomatically correct to bebop. So check out Barry Harris and his teaching. So if we start with measure one, what we have here is a use of bebop scale over the one chord. And it starts on the fifth, up to the sixth, chromatically back down to the fifth, skip down to the third. That is now the chromatic lower neighbor of the fifth of the flat seven dominant seven chord, E flat dominant seven. That sets us up to play a arpeggio off the fifth, flat seventh, and the ninth of that chord. We then go up to the next scale tone, G, which is now the upper neighbor of the third of the sixth chord, G down to F sharp. F sharp, we go up the scale, F sharp, G, A, and this starts our first instance of a Barry Harris 5-4-3-2 lick, this one being 5-4, down to the ninth, up chromatically to the third. It sounds like this. We then skip up to the chromatic upper neighbor of the two dominant seven chord, A flat, down to the root, and then now we're going down chromatically on a G dominant bebop scale. To the ninth, we skip down to the seventh, chromatically up to the root, skip up to the fourth. This is a Barry Harris 5-4-3 lick off the fourth, down to the ninth, chromatically up to the third. We go up to the fifth of this chord, which sets us up to go down by half step to the two chord. So this is basically putting the fourth on the downbeat of the four or the two minor seven chord, which is a great sound. I then play a C dominant bebop scale over the G minor seventh chord. So the G minor seventh chord sounds like this, and we're playing this scale idea. Sounds great. The reason being, you can play anything that you can play over a dominant chord, you can play over its minor seven chord, and vice versa. Anything you can play over a minor seven chord, you can play over its dominant seven chord. So G minor seven is the two chord of C dominant seven, therefore you can play a C dominant seven bebop scale over a G minor seven chord. We stop on the fifth. We then go chromatically up to the sharp nine of the five chord, C dominant seven of the key. This sets us up to go up in consecutive minor thirds to outline a E flat fully diminished seventh chord. Now, I cover this in another lesson. Basically, throughout bebop, we would use fully diminished seventh chords to outline the alterations, flat 9, sharp 9, sharp 11, of dominant chords. This one is starting on the sharp 9, then we go up to the sharp 11, the 6th, or 13, and then the root. We then go chromatically up to the flat 9, down to the root, down to the 7th, down to the flat 6. This is now becoming a surround tone to the third of the one chord. So what we did there is we've just added another little level of chromaticism so we can have a nice half-step resolution to the third of the one chord. So it sounds like this. And that is the F major 7 chord. So once we get to that third, we're going up the scale using a bebop scale passing tone on the flat 6 to keep chord tones on the downbeat. So that's third, fourth, fifth, flat six, sixth, seventh, root. We then skip down to the sixth, And then that sets us up to play a 2-5 flat 9 lick. So these are very common in bebop. And all we're doing here is we're going down a Dorian scale to the third of the dominant chord, skipping up to the flat 9, and then that's going back down the scale to the third of the 4 chord of the key. So that's 2-5 to B flat major. Okay, so that covers the first 8 measures of this exercise. Now, I'd like to say that the rest of the exercise is more of the same. It's just more bebop skills, more Barry Harris type licks. Now, what I'd like to say is if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section. And then also, I have put a link to a PDF file in my Dropbox for a PDF of this exercise. So feel free to look over it. I do have some practice suggestions. One, I would learn this as a continuous eighth note etude and work it up to, say, 300 beats per minute with Drum Genius. That's to get the feel correct, because Drum Genius has a lot of really good drumming feel patterns that feel idiomatically correct to the jazz and will help you with your feel. The other thing is that ultimately, an exercise like this is quite academic, and that's good. It builds up chops and it has a lot of good information, but to really make it your own, what I would recommend doing is taking the licks that are your favorite, the ones that really sound good to your ear, and learning them in all 12 keys to the point where they become yours. Because really, all this stuff is common practice the bebop period. None of it is copyrighted to anybody other than, say, Charlie Parker, Bud Powell, or Dizzy Gillespie. So we're all borrowing this stuff from those great master musicians. And as a result, it's really a matter of what I want to use to make music, because it's really about what I think is cool and what's helping me get the point across. So yeah, that's all I have to say today. Keep playing, and thanks for joining Dana's Jazz Tube.